Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and we're talking mesotherapy and what it is in 2019 and how it applies to our treatments now. I've had the pleasure of working with people who developed this procedure about 20 years ago. So I'm going to take you through the history of it, what it actually is, how it developed, and how are we using this technology in 2019. It is making a comeback. It's all over Instagram and really around the world. It's more used than in the United States. So what is it? Mesotherapy was developed by a guy named Dr. Michel Pistor. He studied in Paris and then he settled in a small town. And how it developed was he realized that people were ingesting substances through the body in order to make a distant organ improved or to create therapy. As an example, knee pain. Instead of taking a pill orally, he thought, why not put the medicine directly around the knee? Then, of course, like everything else, an aesthetic application was found and people started using it for skin. By putting retinol, elements, hyaluronic acid, antioxidants, all those things directly in the skin and providing nutrients, the skin was improving. Then in the early 2000s, it came to America in fat dissolving. And it's a bit of a misnomer because using it to dissolve fat really isn't mesotherapy, but it was coined that. And of course, fat loss is all the rage. And Kybella stemmed from that because deoxycholate and phosphatidylcholine were used for what they call mesotherapy, being a misnomer because really meso means middle layer. And it means putting substances in the middle layer skin, but mesotherapy is deeper into the fat layer. Nonetheless, as we know, it got a bad name in terms of lipodissolve. It was used in the wrong way, and that went by the wayside. Now we have Kybella, and here we sit in 2019 with mesotherapy. Skin boosters, and I talk about plasma boosters using PRF. That's a form of mesotherapy, and several treatments that I'm going to talk about over the next 6 months involve mesotherapy. The purpose of those treatments is to get skin glow. And the reason we're seeing a comeback is because skin glow is valued again. When we see someone and we see beautiful, healthy, vibrant skin that glows, we think they're healthy. They look rested as opposed to looking sickly or tired. It's just something that goes on in the brain. So mesotherapy today, you see it in micro devices, small devices that barely go into the skin, but actually do go into the meso layer to put in nutrients. You see it in the form of micro needling. And that's one of the big reasons we don't see the guns used anymore that were used, the meso guns, the Pistor 3 and 4 and so on, and the electrical guns as much, because micro needling's thought to go in the middle layer and put those nutrients there. And then treatments that I do like PlasmaGlo, you can go to plasmaglo.com and see how we use it there. PlasmaBoosters.com shows the PRF and the Restylane skin boosters all being used for confluence of skin, skin glow, vibrance, and beauty. We do a great job of filling, we do a great job on the structure of the face, and instead of overdoing people, now it's moving towards the surface of the skin and skin glow, which we see globally and we're now seeing in America. So that's a little of the history of mesotherapy, a little bit about how it came to America in terms of lipodissolve, and how we're using it in 2019. Now, a lot of people watch this channel from around the world. We'd love to hear your comments. How are you using it in your country? A lot of people are using AquaGold and different systems like that here. How are you finding those treatments and how are your patients being receptive to them? In the comments below, let us know. Also go to Instagram and follow us there for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.